In this last example, we want to approximate the area under the same function, f of x equals 4 divided by x, on the same closed interval from 1 to 5, but now we want to use 8 right-sided rectangles. So again, we'll start by marking off the interval from 1 to 5. So we're going to start here and stop here. And now we want to divide this into 8 equal parts. If we wanted to, we could use this formula here to determine the width of each interval, labeled delta x, where a would be 1, and b would be 5, and n would be 8. So let's go ahead and use the formula this time. Delta x would be equal to 5 minus 1 divided by 8, which would be 4/8, or 1/2. So this tells us the width of each interval would be 1/2 of a unit. So there are the 8 equal intervals, and now we want to use the right side of each interval to determine the rectangle's height. So looking at this first interval, we'll use f of 1/2 or f of 3/2 for the height of this first rectangle. For the second, we'll use f of 2. For the third, we'll use f of 2/2 or f of 5/2. For the fourth, we'll use f of 3. For the fifth, we'll use f of 3/2 or f of 7/2. For the sixth, we'll use f of 4. For the seventh, we'll use f of 4/2 or f of 9/2. And for the last rectangle, we'll have a height of f of 5. Notice how the sum of the areas of these 8 rectangles would be less than the area under the blue function. So this is often called the lower sum of the rectangles. And again, the idea here is the area under the function is going to be approximately equal to the sum of the area of these 8 rectangles. So we'll say a sub 1 plus a sub 2 all the way through a sub 8. So in general, the area is going to be approximately equal to the sum of f of c sub I times delta x, where I goes from 1 to n, and n represents a number of rectangles. So for this situation, the area is going to be approximately equal to the sum of these 8 areas. So we'll have f of 1/2 or f of 3/2 times the width of 1/2. Again, this is the height times the width. Plus, for the second rectangle, we'll have f of 2 times 1/2. For the third, we'll have f of 2/2 or f of 5/2 times 1/2. Plus, the fourth rectangle has a height of f of 3 times the width of 1/2. Plus, the fifth has a height of f of 3/2 or f of 7/2 and a width of 1/2. Plus, the sixth has a height of f of 4. The seventh has a height of f of 4/2 or f of 9/2 times 1/2. Plus, the last rectangle has a height of f of 5 times 1/2. So if we go back to the previous video just for a moment and compare how we're determining these areas, it's almost the same, except notice that for the right-sided rectangles, we sub in an x value of 3/2 in the function to determine the height, and then we go all the way to f of 5. But for the left-sided rectangles in the previous video, we determined the function value at x equals 1 and went all the way from 1 to 9/2. So I think it's really important to sketch the rectangles to determine exactly how to set these up. Now from here, we're going to go ahead and evaluate this in the calculator. So notice I have the function in y1, and then from the home screen, we can just type in all of this at one time. Instead of using f, we'll use y of 1. So we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and then in parentheses we have 3/2 for f of 3/2 times 1/2 plus vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and we have f of 2, so we'll have y1 of 2 times 1/2. And now I'm going to go ahead and pause the video and type the rest in. Okay, so now I think I have all the information in there. Now we can press enter. It gives you a decimal approximation, but if we press math, enter, enter, we can determine the fraction value. So it's 3,601 all over 630. So the approximate area under the function is 3,601 divided by 630 square units. And the actual area would be a little bit more than this because this is the lower sum. And from the previous video, the upper sum was 4,609 divided by 360, which means the area under the function would actually be somewhere in between these two values. But using 8 right-sided rectangles, this would be our approximation for the area under the function. I hope you found these examples helpful.